yourself.
Know yourself.
Know your game.
Know your game.
So you are from Atlanta.
Yes.
And your original name was Sir Cartier?
Sir Cartier.
Sir Cartier.
Yeah, like the glasses.
I dang the Zane trying to tell you something. I came in with the core heart.
So, okay. Well, first, so tell us about where in Atlanta?
South Atlanta, Georgia. That's like south of East Atlanta, like where everybody like Gucci and them.
And how long have you been at it music?
You know, I've been doing music all my life, but you know, I got serious around like end of high school, like senior year.
And what kind of music were you making then? I'm curious because right now is a very specific time in music, right? Mm-hmm. And you are like one of the artists who is sort of embodying what this new sound and this new wave of hip hop is.
Right.
But a few years ago when you were in high school, I'm guessing the wave was slightly different. Was your music exactly what it is now? Has it evolved? Take us through.
Sub white powder, clam chowder with your bitch. Snorting up the line, she trying to ease up her mind. Shoot on that black coupe, no gold, black juice. Fuck you and your attitude, I do what I got to. Man, the pot ain't free, stupid knots in my jeans, caviar and ice cream. It seems that I like these nice things, so I'm out here for that cream. He can do the sunroof.
And that's where you spent most of your youth?
Yeah, born and raised.
Okay. Is it that city that drives you creatively?
Yeah.
Really?
I had to get up out of there. That drives me, You know what I'm saying? Had to get up. That the inspiration was to get up out of Atlanta. You know what I'm saying? And when I do go back home, have my shit together.
Okay. I'm just curious, like, why was there a drive to get out of Atlanta?
I mean, Atlanta's what you make it, you know what I'm saying? And at the time, I was just living with my mom. Mm-hmm. You feel me? I knew I wasn't going to college. I had to make a move, so, yeah.
How far along in your life did you know that you wanted to do music for your life? Not just dabble in it and maybe say that you have a song out, but when did you know that you really wanted to take it to a different level?
The moment I realized that it was people out there that liked my music, you know, that pushed me. That was enough.
Here we are in the web.
Yo, when you pulled out, I was like, shit, I didn't even see him look or anything. And then I heard like,
yeah.
I did look, bro, but
you was just swagging on
him. Yeah, I was swagging. Yeah, I was like, fuck the
league. Yeah, I was swagging.
He back. Got the top off. Styling. Hey, just interrupt this lane and shit. Like, this killed this nigga. He bad as fuck. Yo, he wanted to beat my ass. He couldn't do shit.
Yes, please.
4 pieces of face paint.
Four.
I knew you won. A piece cheese dip and one F1.
Huh? Yeah, four, and that's it, man. In the water.
Yeah.
215,
I got you.
How much was that mozzarella stick?
It was like two.
It's 215, man.
215?
It might give me 15 cents.
Alright, cool. Not yet.
Nah, we gotta have hella juices. I got three for that.
Hella hoes.
Hella hoes? We gotta have. Right, no, we gotta have hoes, dope, and a bunch of all the drugs. I'm talking about everything. Yo, for real, nigga, it's gonna happen.
My niggas in the club, drugged out. We don't really give a fuck about. None of these niggas in the club, thugged out. Everybody in this fucking club got gats. All my niggas in this fucking club got racks.
Everybody in this fucking club got shot.
Made up with Ether and Father, man. They had the production going crazy, you know what I'm saying? My flow on those beats just profession, so like we just took off from there, man. Linking with Awful, man, has been a big part of my life also, man. I love all those folks over there, like
Father of Awful Records.
Archer Ball Slim, Awful Records.
It's your boy Cash Cardi of Awful Records, and we live in New York, man. It was popping. I was up in Sandy Springs, and I'm from South Atlanta. I had went to Sandy Springs in high school and met up with my nigga Ethereal. And then since then, you know, we just clicked up. You know, I met Father and shit, you know. They was fucking with how I rap, you know. I really freestyle my shit. They would just be playing beats and shit, and I just come off top, you know what I'm saying? They was just like, yo, gotta fuck with us, bro. They want me to stay out of trouble and shit, just get to this money. I mean, that's what this shit is. So, you know,
I let everybody kind of run wild and do what the fuck they want, honestly. It's not really,
if anybody is doing too much, then you got that family dynamic where somebody sits you down and say, hey, you doing too much, sit the fuck down.
You fucking up, calm down.
Yeah,
like,
but it's pretty much democratic.
Everybody's just constantly working at the same time. I mean, there's so, the numbers are so big. The numbers are so big that it's just gonna, somebody's gonna always be dropping. It's impossible not, you know, for us to just, for like a group of 15 to just sit still for a month and not release anything. It doesn't really make any sense.
Shit, we record every day, really. We be up in the barrio just, you know, make, if we ain't trapping it up, we fucking recording. Everybody's recording, you know, everybody be straight out doing their own thing. But at the end of the day, we all about music, like that's what we do.
Who got beef for me? Who got beef for me? Who got beef for me? Who got
beef with me. I got niggas in the streets do 7 years for me. Yeah, kill for me. R.I.P. R.I.P. Got a hoe all in my bed, she going free for me. I spin a bag and get it back. I flex like a Hercules. I can't wait to be for who got beef with me. I talk that guap with this. She tryna rock with me. And pop her eyes with me. I ball like broccoli. Just Ross and Robin James. She can't stop topping me. That's why he plot on me. That's why he jack on me. Cause I get on the beat and answer like it's calling me.
Get up out of it, about it, had to get up out of it. That drives me. You know what I'm saying? Had to get up, daddy, get inspiration. You know what I'm saying? And when I do go back home, have my shit together. Had to make a move.
Shout out to A$AP Rocky, man. Shout out to all. Rocky signed me, you know what I'm saying? We got a lot of shit coming up, about to drop, like, probably 5 bangers. Nothing's really changing. It's just about to be bigger and better, you dig? You know?
Who first reached out to you and said, man, you are really good at this?
A$AP Mob.
A$AP Mob. That's what took you from one level to get to the next.
Yes.
A lot of artists with A$AP Mob, of course. Did that feel like some validation when they reached out to you and said, we really like what you're doing?
Honestly, that shit felt crazy, bro. Because it's like a lot of, there wasn't too many people that could tell me anything at the time. And that's who I was listening to all the way in South Atlanta. I was knowing about how the boys was coming to Harlem because of Rocky. So once he reached out to me, that was just crazy, bro. Like, what?
And what was the first meeting like? Was it an office building, someone's house?
With some bitches.
If I can make it there, I'll make it. Anywhere, it's up to you. New York, New city that never sleeps, and find I'm a number one, top of the list, king of the hill, a number one. These little town blues.
shit. Well, he has his shirt on right now. Yeah. Show him the shirt.
Yeah, this shit fire.
Got the.
Okay.
So, it's a family.
Life's
it's like,
a family. You know,
it's like, messages. It's like a family. It's nothing without a family if a family don't eat together. You feel me? And it's like, it's a brotherhood. It's like, we, as an ASAP member, and them being new members of ASAP, you know, it's like, we look at them as, I die over them, you know? Mm-hmm. Like, that's my little brother, like, you know?
I'm Cardi.
I'm Ian.
I'm Young Lloyd.
I knew Cardi since he was young on some, like, everybody that I meet is where I actually meet them through fashion or a piece of something that I like. So Cardi, I used to, you know, I'd just be on the internet all day. I saw a shirt that he had. It was a girl that I actually like used to talk to or whatever.
He was fucking with the same bitch.
Long story short, yeah. She set it up. Cardi pulled up. He brought me the shirt. Yeah. But from now, I just like Cardi's, like as much clothes as I get from people and stuff like that. I just like Cardi's art. So I used to keep Cardi around. I didn't know that he rapped. And to my prior assistant, to who I have now, played this music, and Bar used to play Cardi's music. I said, this the same Jordan? This the same Cardi? Yeah.
Nah, nigga, I just thought he was just cool, like a cool kid, you know? And then like I was coming from Atlanta, South Atlanta, you know what I'm saying? Like, I always thought I was the shit, but these was the niggas I was like getting the shit from, you did? So like, when I met that nigga, I was like, yo, bro, like, you know what I mean? Like, it wasn't not like on the like fan shit. It was just more like, yo man, I fuck with you, bro. Like, I'm trying to get up. You did, you know what I'm saying?
That's what Rocky is. He teaches. That's like a father figure in my life. That's a big brother, just the same way Bari is.
What you could say is we are the new internet.
Yeah.
You understand? Like, without we take over the internet with everything we do, from fashion to music to whatever
lifestyle in general.
So. If you're looking for the fresh shit, you either gotta come to Cardi shit or Ian shit or my shit or just anybody near us. We know about the hottest young niggas like from the last past 2 to 3 years. Like, you feel me?
Shout out to the star in Boston. Man's heavy down. New shoes.
That's what, the rest.
Yeah.
Is that where you met Ian?
No, I met Ian in Atlanta around like, shit, 2011. It was on some young nigga shit. I'm driving the car before I had a license, pulling up, bitches, getting high, getting fly, same shit. And then, you know, our relationship grew and shit, and then later on, I don't know what happened, you know, I stopped fucking with Bari. Bari started playing my music. Even put Ian into my shit. Bari had to put my man's on this shit.
Damn! Soon as I give him my timeline, you was a different nigga.
Is this your first time in the city, nigga?
Huh?
Yeah. First time in the city?
First time in the bitty.
Great ain't footage, stuff.
It's gonna be But look, in Atlanta, that's when it first popped off. I was the hottest nigga at that shit because I was still in school, bro. Look, I'm still in school working at H&M. But anyway, I'm like this. I'm blessed.
Look who we came from, bro.
I'm blessed. You see this? Rocky gave me this, babe. You know what I'm saying?
No man came to us to get a lunch.
I'm blessed. I'm supposed to be here. My mom and dad, you know what I'm saying? They ain't go to college, but nigga, they ain't have me, bro. Yo, Rocky is, I love that nigga, bro. Just like I love Father and I love Ether. I love these niggas, bro. And I love Key to death. Niggas is cancer. Niggas can't say nothing. And niggas, look, only niggas can say to me, they can be like, oh, they can. Some niggas can say I changed on them because I thought they was on the same shit I was on, but they not. Or they was on some shit that I wanted to be on, and when I got on that shit, I got on it and then surpassed them, and they was just lost in the sauce. I'm like, damn, how the fuck you gonna, nigga, you ain't even
boring.
Nigga, you not even practicing what you preach, my nigga. Only nigga that can kill me right now is Ian Connor. You know why he killed me? Because that's my brother. He can shut me down. But any other nigga on this rap shit, I don't give a fuck if you 50 Cent, K, king of the trash talk. You can't shut me down, nigga.
I met my twin. It's weird. I went back up there to work with an artist, 5 a.m. His manager introduced me to K Supreme, Yachty's brother. Gave K Supreme some beats. And the next time I saw him in the studio, he told me Cardi got on the beat. But I was confused. I was like, I gave those beats to you, bro. Like, why did you do that? Like, why? I was mad. Like, I was upset. I really was upset. And then he showed me the video. It was on Instagram. It's the video of him in the car playing Woke Up Like This. Of Cardi in the car playing Woke Up Like This. We linked maybe like 2 weeks later. And it's just been cooking up ever since. When we did Magnolia, that was like right before South By. And then I skimmed through a bunch of beats. And I didn't think he was going to like the Magnolia beat because it sounded different than like the Woke Up beat or Do That Shit. Like, just the bass line. Like, it's different. It's more aggressive, it's more angry. So I just didn't expect him to want to do that because we were doing so many cool ass songs. But when I press play, he's like, nah, go back, what was that? Pulled it up, he went in there, and I was recording him this time, right? So I was like, yep, put my tag all on this bitch. Like, when I go run on stage, I'm like, yo, Pierre, you wanna come out here? Like, it's fucking crazy.
I am, run that shit back. In New York, I'm in Lyra. I lean in my socks. Running from my office. And I shoot at up.
So Cardi, welcome, man. I know
you've had a
really great run recently. That record Magnolia is blowing up for you.
Yeah, going real crazy.
Yeah, you having
Who's
fun?
Who's Pierre?
He's right there.
Oh, that's Pierre.
Let's be clear. Let's just be totally honest about it. Pierre's fucking lit out here right now.
Yo, Pierre is lit.
How lit is your man right now?
He's lit. I'm so happy for him.
He's got the fresh Supreme right now.
Fresh shoes, fresh gear,
everything's clean. Everything's clean. And his name is Pierre, so let's be honest. You kind of got a rep to start out with. When you have a French name, there's a certain expectation of your flyness that's expected.
Yeah, I was at the Travis Scott show at Terminal 5. I was there. So when Travis brought him out and the record dropped, the Magnolia record dropped, it ripped in there.
Yeah.
Travis was like, y'all been listening to his album nonstop, man.
Yeah.
How does your mom feel about your music career now?
She loves it. Like, at first, like, she didn't understand, like, other people had to tell her. You know, uh-huh. Like, her sister's like, yo, you see nephew going crazy? Send her the links and stuff. now she, you know, she just sent me everything. Like I wasn't even the one doing it. Like, yo, like, it's just crazy. She just
so said, she finds little things online and sends it to you?
You seen this? You seen this? You know what I mean? So
that's
she's
dope.
She's still living in Atlanta and shit. My dad is out there with her too. So yeah.
Your parents are together?
Yeah.
And where do you spend most of your time? Are you mostly in Atlanta? Are you mostly LA now?
I live in LA. I worked on my album in Atlanta, so I've been in Atlanta for a minute. And I'm moving back to, I'm gonna keep my crib in LA, but I'm moving back to Atlanta so I can just the studio, lock in.
A punk club in Warsaw, Poland, and they used to send us letters all the time, real stilted English and everything, and then we get letters from Madrid and Tokyo, Sweden, all over the place, about punk.
Why do they like it so much?
It's they got to do something with their time, and it's the most fun, so. Nothing else is going on. It's the only form of revolution left, I think.
Lit, man. I really enjoy this project a lot more than the self-titled one, to be honest. How do you feel about how the album is being received, man?
Yeah, it's going crazy. I'm on tour right now. Show's going crazy.
I heard the shows are crazy.
Yeah. Die Lit, different project coming from me, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's more on some, like, a different type of Cardi that I was bringing up, you know?
Yo, what is the live energy at the show? I've been to a Cardi show, and it's, I always tell people, man, it's like some punk rock shit, man. Like, if you go, you better be ready to, you know what I mean? Some mosh pit shit popping off, all of that. 100%, man.
Getting go ahead, riding around on moped. My bitch out the pack of shit. Pop that bean and cat and dead. Yeah, she set me, I can't feel my leg. My bitch yucky, she don't use no hand. That's what with the diamond dance. That's what with the diamonds dance. That way you cut ballin', babe. In LA, I smoke that gas. In LA, I live in slack. Them bitch with you, she gave you back. I'm fit, them bitch and gave it back. I not on her, she make me lax. That gun on me, I cannot let. Yo, bitch, right, she got it clap. It can die by yours, but you can clap. I took that little boy right off of the map. We kill them boy right here, right in the trap. I love my lean, I fucking run, relax. I feel that bitch, he running, running, latch. You touch down in my city, you better tap. That bitch right here, she know she got it tap. I seen that bitch run, running, knew he cat. That bitch with me and now she on the pack. On the south side, no way in the crack. Shut, yeah, honey, get. And shut, and then we black. And shut, yeah. To the lean, yeah. To my eye, one more point, one more point. To my lean, yeah. To my eye, on my bike, yeah. On my bike, on my bike, on my bike, on my bike, on my bike. To my lean, to my eye.
Motherfucking back. I love you, you know. I wanna paint the world red, son.
Everything I say a quote. Everything we put on, we make it look good.
Thank you.
you get him out of the fucking open. Nigga, I love you so much. I love you so much. This fucking baby, I can't motherfucking do this. I love you so fucking much. I want everybody in this bitch, get the fuck out of here and go the fuck home. This shit is over with. I love you. Fuck this shit.
I'll see you tomorrow. I'll see you tomorrow.
In the bag with Cash Cardi, aka Playboy Cardi, all the way from ATO. That's the homie, bro. What's going on, man? How was the show last night?
It was fire, bro.
Yeah? It was lit?
Too lit.
Too lit? What's the best part of being a performer when you're out on stage and you can hear your name?
Just them, the fans.
The fans, yeah.
Bro,
I feel you.
It keeps me going.
Yeah, that's what's up, man. So would you say you were good?
Mm-hmm. That was nice.
What would you say? Would you say you were God or like, two, stretch three.
Like 1 to 10, I said I was a cool 8, man.
Yeah, I like that. I like.
I always love music, you know what I'm saying? But I do focus. Sometimes I make beats and shit. You know what I'm saying? But I said earlier, I don't have a lot of rapper friends, but I have hundreds of producer friends.
Yeah, right.
That's who I keep.
What would be next for you after all the music is done and you sit back and you're like, damn.
Just making sure my family got them. Yeah. They have everything that I had. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, for sure.
I can't just live it up these years and shit. And
yeah.
5 years later, I can't have nothing for my folks.
Yeah, for sure.
Everybody got to feel it. You know what I mean?
So
right now, what I'm trying to do is just expand. Getting ready to like put my label together and shit.
That's what's up.
Yeah. It's not even me taking my time and saying, I'm away to here to drop my shit. I'm with a different producer.
Yeah.
Every day. And it's like, damn, I'm like, yeah, this is the sound right here.
That's what's up. Yeah, yeah.
That's
facts.
So I'm just trying to, when I do drop, I just want people to know, like, I'm going to give you what you love.
Yeah.
And I'm boom. Whole lot of red is just trying to prove these folks that I can rap. I ain't just a fly nigga.
Yeah.
I got bars.
Yeah.
That's what Whole Lot of Red is about.
Where does that motivation come from? Like when you go in the studio, you're like, shit, all right, today I'm going to make this track. How does everything outside influence you? Do you switch off from the rest of the world?
Mm. I don't even listen to shit. You got
yeah. 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 You don't listen to anything that's outside.
Once, yeah, once my shit is out, I listen to
that shit. Yeah.
This is about, I love it.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to protect myself.
Yeah.
You feel me? I don't want to ever
lose by nothing else.
Yeah, I don't want to get informed. Yeah.
That's what's up. I like that.
Yeah. When do we get a new album?
Yeah.
This year.
2020 is a year.
Of course. I'm ready. I'm more ready than y'all.
Trolled with this question all the time. I'm never gonna tell you when Whole Lotta Red is dropping, you guys. You nice try. I can tell you Whole Lotta Red is amazing and it's next level and it's way better than anything any of the other people out here are doing for real. It's like, but I can't tell you what's coming out.
You don't go out in the sun, go out in the sun. You never eat or drink, and you drink anything. I know what you are.
See it.
Cardi fans at. One of the most loyal, most dedicated fan bases I've seen in a while. They wait patiently. I had to damn near sell my soul for this information. The Illuminati owns a part of me. What I also found out, Kanye West is the executive producer, along with Matthew Williams, who work at Givenchy. So maybe that would make sense, some of the pictures he's been posting recently. That's the reason why he said he got a gift for y'all. Nigga, he's Santa. That's the gift, nigga. Okay? This year been horrible. And to be honest, from what I'm hearing, expect a blessing.
Give you a diamond ring, all sorts of danger, all sorts of danger, all sorts of things up. You got me turned out.